No country or business is immune to climate impact. Yet while we have known about climate change for decades, we have been slow to act. We are now on a path to increasing climate impacts that will continue to intensify for the foreseeable future. According to the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, to avoid the worst climate impacts, global emissions must be halved by 2030 and reach net zero by 2050. Yet, despite pledges from countries and companies to reduce carbon emissions, temperatures continue to rise. Without transforming our economies to bring emissions down, we will overwhelm the planet's ability to recover with devastating consequences. International movements and demonstrations are placing increased pressure on governments and businesses to act. Investors, lenders, insurers, and customers increasingly expect businesses to embed climate risks and opportunities into their strategic planning. In the wake of the global financial crisis, the G20's Financial Stability Board established the Task Force on Climate-Related Financial Disclosures, the TCFD, to better understand the risks of climate change to the global economy and to help businesses identify, understand, monitor, and oversee the changes necessary to mitigate climate risks and realize the opportunities associated with a climate transition. The TCFD recommendations provide a global reference for businesses from all sectors to assess and disclose their climate-related financial risks and develop scenario-informed strategies to address climate impact. Given our current trajectory of warming, the resilience of businesses, the economy, society, and Earth's ecosystems are at risk. The TCFD recognizes two categories of climate risks: physical risks and transition risks. Physical risks include damage to assets, supply chain disruptions, impacts on employee health, availability of water for business needs, and the disruptive impacts of drought, flooding, and forest fires. Transition risks include policy, legal, and technological changes, reputation and litigation risks, and market risks and opportunities stemming from the necessary transition to a lower carbon economy. This include greater demands for disclosure, carbon pricing, technology substitution, litigation, changing customer demands, and societal acceptance of your transition strategy. More and more companies are voluntarily disclosing information about their physical and transition risks in their financial filings and reporting. Mandatory climate risk disclosure is sure to follow. New Zealand was the first country to require mandatory climate risk reporting in line with the TCFD guidelines, with several other countries considering or enacting similar mandatory disclosure requirements. Regulation and litigation are two transition risks with the potential to reshape the way businesses think about and respond to climate change. As governments implement policies to drive the low-carbon economy transition, companies will be required to adapt to a new regulatory environment. Carbon pricing systems are being implemented or considered on every continent. Several countries have declared a climate emergency, as have nearly 2,000 municipal governments worldwide. Many countries are prioritizing climate justice in the transition to a low-carbon economy by prioritizing worker retraining and sustainable infrastructure and climate adaptation projects that serve remote and systemically disadvantaged communities, as well as drawing on nature-based solutions that recognize and respect the rights and lands of indigenous peoples. Meanwhile, litigation over climate rights and liabilities is on the rise. Energy companies are facing lawsuits from cities, states, and the public, and governments are facing lawsuits from their citizens, including youth, for failing to protect the right to a healthy future. The evolving landscape of climate risks and societal expectations has significant implications for future business success.